Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. This is Trusty Rusty Depot, and today we're going to be going over how to configure your Starship prompt. The first thing we need to do is open up our terminal, which is Alacrity. So command space and type in Alacrity if you're on Mac. And then we can figure out where our configuration file is stored, if you have one. So usually the configuration file is located in /.config/ and then starship.toml. Now, if you don't have one already, you need to go over to this home, which is the tilde symbol /.config, and then create a file by saying touch and then starship.toml. Now we can open the file. You can use your favorite editor. I'm going to use NeoVim, so I'm going to say nvim and then starship.toml. And you can tap complete the name of the file and then press enter. And we have a nice blank file that we can write in. First thing you need to know is that this is in TOML format, and TOML format works like this. Basically, each time you have a value and then an equal sign, and then whatever you want it to be equal to. You can say either quotes and put something in quotes, or you can put brackets and have a list of strings. That is the basic of TOML. In addition to that, we have headers, and a header is a pair of brackets, and inside of it you put the name of the header, and then underneath there are some values. The first value we have is called a format value, and it basically says what order you want the modules. The modules are each of the sections of the prompt to be in. So if we put just quotes and nothing inside of them, if we save and close this, you can see that our prompt now is just nothing. There's nothing in the prompt. So if we go back to the file, we can write something in here. We could put an arrow like this. And now our prompt is just the arrow. If we want to make it colorful, put color into it, we need to put a bracket around the arrow and then parentheses and say, for example, blue. And then save and close. And now the arrow will be blue. So that's how coloring works. And that is the first value inside the TOML file, starship.toml. But we're going to leave it to the default, which is all. It has the dollar sign in front of it because it's a variable and it stands for just all of the modules that are there. So now we're back to how it was before. The next part is that there's a header value for each of the modules that are available. And I encourage you to look through each of them and change what you want. I'm just going to give a few examples. The first one I'm going to show you is called the line break module, and it controls whether there's a carriage return or an enter after the information in the prompt. The only value in this header, in this module, is disabled. And we can say it's equal to true or equal to false. And we're going to say true. If we save it, we can see that there's no more enter after the information. Another header that we can have is the Rust header, which will show the Rust version. And each of these language modules, there's many of them, have a couple of different fields that are pretty similar. So we have the symbol field, which is the text or symbol that will come before what the version or whatever information about that language we have. So I'm just going to put Rust, And then we have the field style, which is where we can just put whatever style we want. So we can say bold and red. And then we have the format value, which is what order we want the information to go in. So we have a couple of variables we can use, and we can put brackets around it to color it. So we can say the symbol, whatever symbol we had before, and then we can say the version, and then we can put parentheses afterward and say the style, whatever style we pick. And if we save and close that, we can see that we have right here the module of Rust with our keyword Rust, and then the version. We can also control the version format, and we can say that it'll have the letter V and then the raw version of Rust. So we can see that we have V and then the raw version of Rust. And then we can do just the major version of Rust. So now we have just version 1. We can say just the minor version of Rust. We can see version 52. And we can do the patch version of Rust. And that just gives us the last part. And we can combine it. We can do a major colon minor colon patch. And if we save that, we can see that it formats it like that. So that's how the modules work. So you can go through and change whichever parts you want. That's it for configuring Starship. I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.